until your life's end. Let this candle represent your life and how brightly you will live. At the end, your wealth, fame, temporal power will shrivel to irrelevance. It will not matter what you owe or what you were owed. Your grudges, resentments, frustrations, and jealousies will finally disappear. So too, your hopes, ambitions, plans, and to-do lists will expire. The wins and losses that once seemed so important will fade away. It won't matter where you came from or what side of the tracks you lived on at the end. It won't matter whether you are beautiful or brilliant. Even your gender and beliefs will be irrelevant. So what will matter? How will the value of your days be measured? What will matter is not what you bought, but what you bought. Not what you got, but what you gave. What will matter is not your success, but your significance. What will matter is not what you learned, but what you taught. What will matter is every act of integrity, compassion, courage, or sacrifice that enriched, empowered, or encouraged others to emulate your example. What will matter is not your competence, but your character. What will matter is not how many people you knew, but how many will feel a lasting loss when you are gone. What will matter is not your memories, but the memories that live in those who love. What will matter is how long you will be remembered, by whom and for what. Living a life that matters doesn't happen by accident. It's not a matter of circumstance, but of choice. Choose to live a life that matters. Give it your all this year. You only live once.
Thank you, Grade 8. You look beautiful, you look lively. I'm going to ask you...
Put your hand on your heart, and you are going to say your pledge, and we are going to start it together. We, the Grade 8s,
of 2021, pledge our allegiance to Bryanston High School and promise to uphold its name. We will serve our school with pride and honor its traditions. We will participate to the best of our abilities and support our peers in their endeavours. In everything we do, we will strive to be the best we can be for Bryanston High School.
Thank you, Grayling. We will now sing the school hymn.
Come on.
Good afternoon again, Grade 8s. And well done. Every action, except reflexes, starts with a thought. Now that's not a quote by anybody famous. It's what I teach in grade 12. And it's a biological fact. So just because you are in grade 8, I'm just going to take a brief second just to explain what that means. As you are sitting there, you are blinking, your heart is beating, some of the food you ate earlier on is digesting. That is a reflex. You are not sitting there thinking, I must blink, my heart must beat, but that is happening. However, as I said, every action except your reflexes starts with a thought. Let's think of the process of entering the hall. You walked up to the door and you stopped. Why did you stop? Because you've been thinking about what you've been practicing and you thought, when I get to the door, I must stop. And eventually you thought, okay, it's time to walk to the markers in the center. So if we take that statement and we apply it to ourselves as human organisms, in essence, what you think is what you do. Before you do it, you think it. So stop there for a moment and understand that all the things you're going to do and all the things you have done in your 5 years at Bryanston High School are going to be based on what you think. So the easy path is think positive things only. Do away with the negativity. And the more positive you think, the more positive you will do. So let's take your life at Bryanston High School thus far. It's divided into a past, from February when you arrived here until just now before you walked in here, into a present, right now as you are sitting there, and a future. And let's apply some of this positive thought. Because quite easily, you could focus on the negative, on the fact that, oh, we're only doing our grade 8 induction in September. We can't have our parents here. We've had no sport. We haven't gone away on camp. Those are the negative thoughts we could engage in. However, if you choose to apply positive thoughts to that, you could, number one, take your past and choose rather to focus on learning from that past. Learning to appreciate what you have, because you don't know when some COVID regulation is going to snatch it away from you. That you are given an opportunity now to participate in athletics, whatever sport, that you are given the opportunity to be in class and have your teachers teaching you. Choose to focus on not taking that for granted. Because quite easily there could be a regulation that says we will not be coming to school anymore because COVID numbers have become so inflated. Then you'll be stuck at home, having to endure online lessons. So based on your past and the experience that things can be taken away from you, rather choose to appreciate what you have now. Then in terms of your present and your future, please understand, Denzel Washington once said, without commitment, you will never get started. Without consistency, you will never finish. So commit to those positive thoughts. Commit to engaging in them. And then be consistent in your actions. Don't put your name down for a school activity. So you've committed to the activity. Then you don't consistently attend practices, or you don't consistently spend time studying your work so that you can produce those marks that you have committed to. So commit and be consistent. And then, on a personal note, Tyler Perry, another famous actor, said, "Don't ever change one brush stroke on your canvas because somebody else doesn't like it. Change it only if you don't like it." In the same vein, Steve Harvey said, "Ignore thumb gangsters." Now, in case you don't know what thumb gangsters are, it's those people amongst you who are guilty of sitting there on their cell phones sending these deceitful, these disgusting social media posts. Those are the thumb gangsters. At the end of the day, don't change any of your brush strokes because of them. Change them only because you are unhappy with them. And fail big, but learn from your failures. Thomas Edison, who invented the light bulb, did 1,000 experiments, which all failed, before experiment 1,001 produced the light bulb. So be consistent, be committed, and set goals, and we look forward to having you here over the next 5 years and the many, many achievements you're going to have in that time. Well done on choosing Bryanston High School, grade 8 of 2021. Thank you.
Just for a moment, for Ms. Byrne, can I ask you all just to raise your lights up and let's get a lovely photograph of all of you with your lights. And those are the lights that we hope will shine brightly. You may now switch off your lights. I would like to welcome Brian from the governing body to have a chat to you.
Students, parents, and teachers. Just give me a moment while I try and stop this thing from glitching. On behalf of Bryanston High, the school governing body officially extends our warm welcome to you, joining us for the years ahead. We trust that you will settle into the school comfortably. I won't bore you with all the STB functions and responsibilities. We are essentially a group of like-minded parents who have been nominated and appointed for your benefit to support the functioning, teaching, learning activities of the school. The STB members have a combined active role in a variety of sectors which assist and manage the school operations, services rendered, finances, sporting activities, facilities, maintenance, to name a few. As best as possible, the current SGB aims to establish and maintain a cohesive, functional relationship with staff, educators, students, and parents collectively. We encourage an open door function by the appropriate school channels to facilitate interaction and communication with each other. The SGB is passionate about serving our school community and upholding the values of Bryanston High whilst keeping alive hashtag blue flame camaraderie. We thank you for opting to enroll at BHS, and may you flourish and become champions in all of your endeavors within our school community. Thank you. Thank you.
Would you open the door for me, mate? Perhaps the very door fly out. It is a great joy and a great privilege to thank you for coming through today. We know you've taken time out of your schedule. And I would love to introduce to you the four wonderful people who are most dedicated to you for the next 5 years. Mrs. Bookris, who unfortunately has a holiday today for her religious beliefs. Mr. Maudsley, if I can ask him to stand, please, who is going to be looking after the boys very well for the next 5 years. Mrs. Hurry Lowell, who will be helping Ms. Bookris, and Mr. Mangray, who will be assisting Mr. Maudsley. Let's give them a round of applause. I would now like to call on Mr. Maudsley to give you a few words.
It was very convenient that Mr. Lawrence spoke to you about Thomas Edison and how many times he has tried before getting the light bulb right. Because the opening quote to my message to you today, Grade 8, is from Thomas Edison, and he says, "Our greatest weakness lies in giving up. The most certain way to succeed is always to try just one more time." On behalf of the Grade Controlling Team, I would like to officially welcome you as the Grade 8 of 2021. We really do look forward to sharing this new chapter of your lives with you, and it's an honor to be by your side on your journey through high school. And we will do everything to continue to make the rest of this journey as wonderful as we can. Now, Grade 8, I'm sure you can agree with me that the start to your high school careers has been anything but normal. You've been faced with so many challenges and changes, but you've embraced them and you've got on with it. In this very complicated year, we've seen some of you participate in your first ever rugby or netball or hockey match. Some even trying their hand at debating for the first time or chess. And then COVID threw us another curveball and everything was cancelled again. But that being said, you never gave up. You got back up and you carried on pushing through. And we really do look forward to a happy and a successful journey together. And we can't wait to watch you continue burning that blue flame bright. Parents, you can be so proud of these young ladies and young gentlemen sitting here today. They have embraced the challenges and the changes that have been thrown at them, and they really have shown resilience. We're looking forward to seeing them grow in immaculate ways alongside you. And we're looking forward to hearing the many success stories that come through their times at Bryanston and after they matriculate. Grade 8, we know that you will continue to make us and your parents proud in the remaining years you have here at Bryanston High School.
Thank you, Mr. Maudsley. I fear we should have put in some English clubs, the only science ones today, but never mind. I'd now like to introduce the parents to Tukunda Gatawa, our head boy. You of course know him, and he has a few words for his grade 8.
Good afternoon, staff, a virtual good afternoon to the parents, and a special good afternoon to the grade 8s. I would like to start by congratulating you on drawing close to the end of your first year of high school. Now, it may seem insignificant, but I believe that milestones should be acknowledged, no matter how small they are. So grade 8s, please may you give yourselves a short round of applause. The Grade 8 induction is a momentous occasion here at Bryanston High School, and it is such a shame that we were unable to hold this special occasion earlier on in the year. But as they say, better late than never. I hope that you all take pride in the fact that you are the future leaders and role models of Bryanston High School, and it is your duty to act accordingly as of today. from today up until the last day, up until the day you take your last steps out of the school. Veritas fidelitas and justitia. Now, I'm sure you all know where these words come from, but for those of you who don't, these three words are the words on your school badge, and they translate to truth, faithfulness, and justice. Hold these three words dear to you, and display these three characteristics throughout your lives. As you come close to your grade 9 year, I would encourage each of you to reflect on this year. Think of the challenges you may have faced being a grade 8, and what do you think could have made these challenges easier to face? Next year, I challenge you to put yourselves in the shoes of the grade 8, because the challenges they will face will most likely be similar or the same challenges that you faced in your grade 8 year. Be leaders and role models to the grade 8s, and give a helping hand wherever you can, because at the end of the day, everyone who puts on the Bryanston High School uniform is your brother and sister, not your enemy. Be an inspiration to your fellow Bryanstonians, whether it be staff or peers. High school will not be easy, and it will be full of ups and downs, but I'll tell you this, high school will be what you make of it, no matter what you face. Over the next 4 years, I want you to all be fearless. Do not worry about making mistakes. Rather, learn from these mistakes. Pick yourselves up and refuse to be defeated. I'll end in saying that your age does not restrict the magnitude of the impact you can make. So, make sure that impact is positive. Grade 8s, I truly believe in every single one of you. And I believe that you can achieve anything you put your minds to. You guys are a strong group, and although we've had our ups and downs, I've thoroughly enjoyed working with you. And I am proud that you are the grade 8s of 2021. And more importantly, I am proud that you are the matrics of 2025. Thank you.
Right, grade 8s, can I ask you to put your candle into the pocket of your blazer? You are going to stand up. All together, can you stand up, please? And your counselors have got a last goodbye for you. All the counselors could come to the front, please.
Okay guys, you guys must join us in on the next Money on Zero, please. Okay.